Apps are what make our smartphones smart. Now there's more than 1.5 million to choose from. But with each new app you download, you may be giving up your personal data to more companies.
Don't always, you know, trust the most popular app.
Researcher Dan Hastings discovered privacy violations in some of the most downloaded robocall blocking apps.
So I found that a bunch of these apps were leaking personal data to third-party companies.
It's a practice that's commonplace among apps in all categories. Details about what data is collected and where it goes are often buried in lengthy privacy policies that consumers can rarely read or understand. A recent review of 150 privacy policies in the New York Times found the vast majority were above a college reading level.
Even when you understand it, you don't really have alternatives.
A simple first step to data privacy: don't go with the default settings. On many apps, you can limit permissions, such as location tracking, or opt out of data gathering altogether. You can also protect your privacy by cleaning out your device. The average smartphone user has 80 apps, but only uses around half of them each month.
If it's possible to use the web browser version of that app, you should just do that instead.
It may also be a good idea to consider the potential privacy trade-off before you press install. Liz McLaughlin, NBC News.